Check this out. I'm inside my car. This is the button to put the window down. Watch this. This is not my window. That's all ice. The whole thing is ice. Look, watch this. It's incredible. Now, check this out. Okay, watch, I'm gonna punch it. Ready? Wow. Look at that. Look at that. Crazy. Look, just look. There's chunks of ice.
Extreme Trends presents, a toddler tries so hard to unlock dad's iPad that it ends up locked for over 47 years. Before we begin, do us a favor and click that like button. Also, subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell to be inspired by these heartwarming stories every day. If you are a parent of young children, you'll understand how hard it can be to stop your little ones from playing with your iPad or iPhone. It's a very different world than it was just a few years ago. While previous generations could only dream about some of the things science has provided us, these advancements are available to us now. Kids today have access to things like iPads and modern laptops. Technology has run rampant, and interactivity is everywhere. Children particularly have embraced the electronic products now on offer and are becoming comfortable with digital interactivity. The solution is simple. Lock it. Evan Osnos is a staff writer at The New Yorker. He's based in Washington, D.C., where he lives with his three-year-old. It was last April when Evan was a bit busy working on something until he decided to look at his son, who was too quiet and busy as well, only to find out that Evan's three-year-old child tried to unlock his iPad many, many times, apparently. Usually people will give up after a few tries, since they don't want their devices to end up locked out for too long. Clearly, Evan's toddler was not giving up, because when Evan picked up his iPad, the screen reported that it was disabled for precisely 25,536,442 minutes, and that is 48 years to be exact. Gradually, every iPad and iPhone automatically disables after several incorrect passcodes. It starts at 1 minute and then gradually increases to 5 minutes, 15 minutes, 60 minutes, and so on. In other words, Osnos would have to wait 25 million minutes, or 48.58 years, somewhere in 2067, nearly half a century later, in order to access his iPad again. Thinking of the best possible solution to solve the problem, the father, Evan Osnos, took to Twitter to post a screenshot of his iPad, asking for advice. He tweeted, this looks fake, but alas, it's our iPad. Today, after my three-year-old tried repeatedly to unlock it. Ideas? Unfortunately, a handful of Twitter users responded to Osnos' plea. They came forward to offer him some helpful and not-so-helpful ideas. People on Twitter could not believe Evan's situation. One person recommended that he reboot his three-year-old, which is a little drastic and comical. Some users speculated about how exactly the toddler managed to get himself into this situation, which honestly, we'd love to know as well. People had all kinds of solutions for Evan, including traveling forward in time to the year that the iPad is finally unlocked, or putting it in a bag of rice. That fixes, like, everything, right? As per LifeWire, this isn't actually the real amount of time you need to wait. That message just represents a really, really long time. It's designed to get you to take a break from entering passcodes. Amidst all the various suggestions, a Twitter user named Xavier Brocart recommended a well-documented solution to the problem. Whilst user Glenn Fleischman shared, "Here's a step-by-step guide from Apple with a link that he can click and follow the instructions. There are a few possible ways to regain access. The best options are to restore from iTunes, go into recovery mode, or DFU mode, or use iCloud to remotely wipe the device. Unfortunately, all of these solutions involve starting over and losing some or all of the data on the device. This is why it's always a good idea to back up your devices on a regular basis. On Monday, April 8th, Osnos told New York Daily News in an email that he was still locked out from his iPad. It's down a few hundred minutes from yesterday, but it looks like we've still got 25 million minutes to go, he said. On Twitter, people have suggested various fixes, but the consensus seems to be that we're using an old operating system that won't let us restart fresh from iTunes. As stated on the Apple website, if users are not able to wait out the lock time, they will need to remove their passcode and perform a restore using iTunes or other methods. However, if you never backed up your device beforehand, the data will be irretrievably lost. Finally, later on April 8th, Osnos managed to restore his iPad by putting it into device firmware update mode, as per other Twitter users' advice. From there, Evan tweeted an update about his iPad, saying, "Update on toddler iPad lockout. Got it into DFU mode."